is just making sure that they have enough energy in the ration. Obviously, in cold temperatures, they burn a lot of calories just staying warm. And cattle are very adapted in this area to doing that, and they don't really have any trouble, especially if they have shelter from the wind.
Dr. Trent Wennekamp advises producers know precisely what's in the cattle's food. Producers have rations saved up by the fall, and a balanced ration is important for maintaining body weight and body condition in the winter. This is critical, especially for cows ahead of calving season.
Particularly the forages. So we're talking your silages and your hays and your green feed, or all those forage products that you're feeding, which is the largest part of any cow ration, right, is the forage. They get usually a small amount of what we call concentrates, so grains, oats, barley.
70% of cost is in animal feed, so a balanced ration avoids a lot of challenges going foul, including having to call the vet when the nutrition isn't right. Rations also need to be tested.
Like, there's different labs that do it. So labs, particularly there's labs in Winnipeg and Calgary are kind of the main ones. And so you can bring it here and we'll send it in. Agronomists will send it in. Different feed companies will send it in. So lots of people will do that service.
The lab gives a nutritional analysis, and then producers can further supplement for protein, energy, minerals, vitamins, and some digestive factors. The vet can also blood test the herd.
Sometimes we do some testing to see if their vitamin and mineral levels are correct, and that's particularly if there's been a problem. We'll go into a cow herd and see if, you know, there's issues that way.
Other issues include forages, which lose their vitamin content over winter, so in the spring when it's needed for calving, producers need to supplement.
For example, vitamin C levels can be very low, vitamin A levels, vitamin E levels, and those things are all really crucial for producing healthy calves and keeping the cows healthy as well.
The problem shows up in calves, so producers can give vitamin E and selenium injections when calves are born. Another deficiency is copper.
It can be a hard one to supplement because other components of the diet can reduce their copper levels, so iron in the water, molybdenum in the feed can tie up copper and reduce copper levels. And copper is really important in immune function and some other factors in getting cows pregnant and things like that.
Producers also need to know about doing body condition scoring on their cattle.
In Canada, we typically go on a 5-point scale, so 3 being ideal, you know, 4 and 5 are too fat, and 2 and 1 are too skinny. And so we just kind of recommend that guys know how to adjust rations based on, you know, making sure that body condition score is correct.
Gerard Lampau, Primetime Local News.